Hey, I'm Hunter from SkillThrive, and in this quick course, you'll create three different website navigations using CSS Flexbox. If you'd like to download the course files, including the final code, all you have to do is become a free member on SkillThrive.com. The link is in the description. After you join, you'll get instant access to these course files and all of our current free courses. With that out of the way, let's get started. To start, I'm going to come into my desktop and we'll create a new folder here and just call this Navbar. And within this, I'm going to create three folders just numbered 1 through 3. And this is just going to represent the three different types of navbars that we're going to be creating in today's course. Then you can see here that I have this image folder already here in my desktop. And that's just a quick logo that I made in Sketch. And that's going to be included in the course files. And what you can do is just copy this folder and I'm just going to paste it into each of these right here. And then once we do that, we can head into Visual Studio Code. I'm going to come up to File, Open, and then head into my desktop, then into Navbar, and then open the first project. Then once this opens up, we can go ahead and click here to add a new file. And here I'm going to do index.html, and then I'm going to create another file, and we're going to call this one styles.css. Then let's head into the index here, and I'm going to type out HTML. You can see here that I have HTML5 boilerplate, which is a plugin that I actually installed in Visual Studio Code. So once we click that, it just gives us some boilerplate out of the box. So I'll be sure to include this in the descriptions as well as a course file in case you want to install this on your Visual Studio Code as well. Now let's go ahead and just edit some of this stuff. So I'm going to get rid of this. I'm going to add a title here, something like Navbar. I'm going to leave the description blank. Style sheet is also going to be important. So styles.css. Let's go ahead and get rid of this comment. Go ahead and get rid of the script tag. And then in between the body, we can go ahead and add a header tag. Then I'm going to pull in the image, and that's going to be a class of logo. And the source is going to be images, logo SVG. And on alt, we can just give that something like just logo, something simple for this case. And now what we can do is go ahead and use nav. So I'm going to create a nav tag. And here is where our links are going to be. And I'm going to use a unordered list and give that a class of nav links. All right, so now we did that, we need each list element, and on that, it's going to have a link inside of it, so a tag, and the href here is just going to be a dummy link, so it's just going to be a hashtag, and that's going to close that off, and inside here, I'm just going to do services, then I'm going to copy this first link, and then paste it in twice, and just go ahead and change the name here to different things, so let's do projects, and the next one could be about. All right, so now we're almost done. All we have to do now is go ahead and do the button. And here I'm going to do another tag or a link tag. And on this, I'm just going to call this a CTA with href equal to a hashtag. Then I'm going to put a button in the middle of a tag. And on here, we can just call that contact. And then we can just go ahead and save it. And that's everything we wanted to do with our HTML. Now let's go ahead and open this up. You can see here that we have the basics, content here for our nav. Now let's go ahead and jump into the styles and start writing everything we need here. Now, the first thing we want to do is pull in the Google font that we're going to be using. So let's head back to fonts.google.com. I'm going to type in Montserrat. I'm going to add it here and then come down here, click on customize. I actually just want the medium 500, so untick the regular, come up to embed and then to at import and just pull in the stuff in between the two style tags. Then we can just import this at the top of our CSS. And then I'm going to add some styles here that override everything. So let's go ahead and do box sizing, and that's going to be border box, margin is going to be 0, padding is going to be 0, And on the background color, I'm going to just add like a dark gray. So 2-4-2-5-2A. All right, now what I'm going to do is just go ahead and add some styles here for the font. So list, we'll also want that to apply the A tags and also the button. And here's where we're going to set the font family to that Montserrat that we pulled in. And the fallback here is just going to be sans serif. The font weight is going to be 500, which is also what we pulled in from the Google font. And the font size is going to be 16 pixels. The color is going to be an off-white, so we're going to do ECF0F1. And the text decoration is going to be set to none. Next up, we're going to target the header. And here we're going to actually place the display flex. And here we're going to do justify content. In the setting we're going to have is space between. And what that's going to do is it's going to push the left and right item to the far edges. And then the item in the middle, it's going to evenly space between those two. All right, so now let's do align items center. And that's just going to take everything in the header and then center it on one another. And next up, we're going to add some padding here. So let's do 30 pixels on the top and bottom, and then 10% on the sides. All right, so let's go ahead and just save this and come back into our browser and refresh this page. So you can see here, the logo and the contact button are both pushed to the far edges, and then we have the nav section here equally distanced between both of these. So you can see here, just with a couple things, it's already starting to kind of, you know, look like it's really close. There's just a couple more things we want to do here. And the first one is to go ahead and add some stylings for the logo. And on this, we just want to do a cursor pointer. So when we hover over it, it's going to turn into a cursor. Then on nav links, I'm going to set a list style to none. And then after that, we can do the nav links as well, and then target each individual item. And on here, we want to do display inline block. So they're instead of going up and down, they're side by side. And on the padding, I want to do 0 on the top and then 20 pixels on the left and right. Then what we can do is go ahead and target the nav links items, but also the A tags that are within them. And here we're going to do a transition of all 0.3 seconds. We'll have an ease on that, so it's nice and smooth and there's going to be no delay, so 0 seconds. Then I can go ahead and just copy this. And after this A tag, I want to type in hover. So this actually is when we have our mouse over it. And on here, I'm just going to change that color to a nice blue color. So let's do 0088A9. And next up is the button styles. So just do button. Padding is going to be 9 pixels and then 25 pixels. Background color is going to be set to an actual RGBA, because when we do the hovered, we're going to actually drop the opacity. So it needs to be RGBA, because RGBA has the alpha value or the opacity. And on here, it's going to be 0, 1, 3, 6, 1, 6, 9, and then just 1 for the alpha value. Then next up, we're going to do border none. Then border radius is going to be 50 pixels. Cursor is going to be pointer, and transition is going to be the same up here. So let's go ahead and just copy this transition here, and I'm going to paste it in. And next up, and the last thing we want to do is just go ahead and actually just add the button hover. And it looks like I missed the pointer, so let's type that in. Okay. And fix that typo. Cool. So now let's do button hover. And on here, we just want to copy this background color and change the alpha value here to 0.8. All right, so let's go ahead and save that. And now when we refresh this, we can see that we have the basic design here for our first nav. So once we hover over this, you can see the links change. And once we hover over the contact, it should kind of, you know, get a little darker because the opacity is blending in with this black background. So now that we did the first nav, let's go ahead and start doing the second nav. And I'm going to come back into my desktop here and copy the index and HTML. And excuse me, I'm going to copy the index and styles and then paste them here. Then I'm going to head back to Visual Studio Code and open that folder. So let's head back to 2. And we don't actually want to change anything in the index. We just want to come into these styles. And there's a couple things that we want to change here. So the first one is justify content. So instead of justify content as space between, I'm going to do flex end, and that's going to push everything to the right. So let's go ahead and just save that and show you the changes as they happen. But first we need to open this up. And now you can see everything's been pushed to the right. So now what we want to do is make the logo just flow over to the left. And to do that, we can come into logo, and I'm just going to add margin right, and then set that to auto. And then once we save that and refresh, you'll see the logo is floating way over here to the left. And everything now, once we hover over, has that styling. Now, I think there's just one more thing that we want to do here, and that is to add a little bit spacing here on the contact. So let's come into the styles here, scroll down to the button, and let's add a margin left of just 20 pixels. And once we save that and refresh it, you can see now that everything is evenly spaced out. All right, so now that we did that, you can see that we have another version of our navbar. So let's go ahead and start on the third one. And to do that, I'm just going to come into the first one actually and copy the index and styles and then paste that into 3. Then head back to Visual Studio Code. Let's go ahead and open up the third project here. Come into our styles, and on the logo, you can actually use something with Flexbox called order, which allows you to actually set the order of child elements. So for here, we want the logo to be to the far right, but in the HTML, it's actually the first thing. So what we want to do is just type in order and then give this a value of 3. And we also want to do margin left. We want to set that to auto so it pushes it to the far right. Next up, we want to target the nav. Now, we didn't do this in the other ones because we didn't want to specifically set the order of this. And the order of this is going to be set to 1. So let's go back into our HTML and just talk about why we have to target the nav. And the reason is that we set the display flex to the header, and the nav is a direct child of it. So this image here, which is the class of logo, the nav, and this a tag, which has the class of CTA, are all children of it. And that's what we need to target when we want to change the order. All right, so now that we did that, the next thing we want to do is go ahead and change the CTA order. So let's come down here and create a CTA class and set the order here to 2. Now let's go ahead and save this. Let's come in and open up the third index here. And you can see here that everything looks pretty good. There is some weird spacing here that we need to fix. And also, too, remember that we added padding to this. So if we come in and inspect this, you'll see that this list item has a little bit of spacing. So it's really not truly to the far left, but we can get rid of that here in CSS. So the first thing I'm going to do is just go ahead and fix the button. And the button needs a margin left of 20 pixels. And to fix that specific link, the first one, copy this. And here we can do nth child. And the child that we want to do is the first one. And then what we can do is just change the padding here. So let's type in padding. And the padding is going to be 0, 20 pixels, 0, 0. So that's going to get rid of that that left padding. So once we refresh this, we see the contact button now has a little bit of padding here. In the services, if we inspect that, the first element doesn't have that left padding. And there you go, that's everything for this quick video. You can see how you were able to create 3 different types of navbars really quickly by just changing a couple things in CSS using CSS Flexbox. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. And also be sure to check out our other design and code courses.